you know, as a young person, your parents might ask you to go and gather dry wood for the fire. So you'd walk in the forest, you'd pick up those dry limbs that fell to the forest floor, and you would take them home, and they would use them to start your fires or in your fires. So that was our way of keeping the forest clean, so that there was very few opportunities to have forest fires. So we know that we fit right into everything that we see around us in creation. But just remind us that that's how your mind works, that you're an intelligent being. There's going to be times in your life where you're going to face hardships. And we talk about that. One of the ways we say every time your life changes, if one life ends and new life begins, we call it the potential to become a gap. Say you might fall out of life during that time, or you might get lost wandering around, or you might get stuck in a repeating pattern. So what we say to you at that time is, there's a bridging. You bridge yourself into your next change, is what we say. And how you do that is with your mind. You throw your mind ahead, and then your mind pulls yourself through any time of darkness or any hard time, is what we say. So however you do that, you envision a dream, you hear a story, you look at the lives of your parents, your grandparents, your great-grandparents, and you see how they pull themselves through. They're living with their own minds. Just to remind ourselves of that.